based on many students' query in YouTube as well as last LMR question, many of them ask the same doubt. CA final examination preparation strategy. Many of our students are written the CA intermediate examination. They want to prepare a final examination, or many final students, they have just joined articleship period. They want to know how we have to prepare for the CA final examination. Now I am going to discuss about CA final examination preparation strategy. Five important things we have to remember for the purpose of clearing CA final examination. Whoever want to clear CA final examination the very first attempt, we have to follow five things. First, I am going to discuss about resource folder. Second one, articleship period. Third one, class. Fourth one, 3:1 rule. And last one, mobile. So the five things, how we have to make use so that we can be in the position to clear the CA final examination the first attempt, very first attempt. The first one is resource folder. The moment you are going to prepare for final examination, all students should have the resource folder in your hand, that too in hard copy. In that resource folder, five things we supposed to have. First one, short notes question and distinguish between questions. Second one, MTP. Third one, RTP. Next, MCQ questions and suggested answers. These are the five things supposed to be there in your hand. Now, the first strategy, resource folder. In that resource folder, what and all you supposed to have that to in hard copy. First, short notes question. Take all past examination question paper, either through author's book or scanners or ICA website. You have to gather short notes questions. All the papers, they are having, especially the last question as a short notes question. 16 mark question, or 4:4, 16 mark, or 4:5, 20 marks. So every question paper, the last question, short notes question is there, irrespective of the new scheme or old scheme. Try to gather what are all the questions they asked in the previous examination. Gather the short notes question, jot down, note it down. You have to gather 100 short notes questions and 40 distinguished between questions for each and every subject. Like FR subject, SFM subject, every subject, gather the short notes question as well as distinguish between questions. That will help you for the purpose of preparation and to clear the examination. What are the specialty in short notes question? If you are going to gather short notes question, first you can be in the position to know what are all the questions they are asking in the previous examination, trend for the examination. You came to know the syllabus properly, the technical jargons also properly. Especially addressing the short notes question is very easy when compared to big size question. So you yourself going to restrict your answer after 1 or 2 pages over. Anyway, 2 pages over, 4 more questions are more than sufficient. So we are going to restrict our answer itself. So that much points will be there. After all, gathering points for the short notes question is comparatively easy. So gather short notes question. By way of gathering short notes question and distinguish between questions, you are going to score, you are going to have 16-20 marks in your package. The 16-20 marks, not only 16 mark, in addition to that, whatever the questions you have prepared out of it, same question will come under the 8 mark question also sometime. Therefore, 16+8=24 mark, roughly 25 marks you are going to score by way of gathering the small work. Preparation of short notes question is comparatively easy when compared to all other questions. Don't underestimate, after all, 24 or 25 marks. To clear the examination, you need to minimum 50 marks. 50% of the headache over by way of gathering all short notes question. For that, you don't need to go to the class. Just you can prepare from your end. Per day, if you are going to prepare 5 questions answer after gathering all the questions, your revision is also over. Easily you can clear the examination. So without worrying about the class, in your side, 50% of the pass mark is there. In that resource folder, second one, MCQ questions. Try to gather MCQ questions. The theoretical paper, nowadays they are asking MCQ question. At least 40 marks MCQ has come. Therefore, gather all MCQ questions. 30-40 marks MCQ will be there. 30 marks at least MCQ will be there. Where and all resources available, try to gather all MCQs. In MCQ, for MCQ questions, because past exam, they are not releasing the question paper MCQs. Therefore, we have to gather from institute website, ICA website, Board of Studies website. Sample questions will be there, kindly download. Post exam RTP or MT, post examination RTP or MTP, they can gather MCQ questions alone separately. And all other website, where and all MCQs are available, who are all the authors, who are all the academy, what are all the academy, they publish MCQ question, try to gather. Our private author's book also there. Make sure per subject, we have to gather minimum 1,500 MCQs. Per subject represent what? 2 plus 2, 4 papers, they may have the MCQ. Right? Auditing means minimum 1,500 MCQ is supposed to have. Law means 1,500 MCQ. Just gather minimum 1,500 MCQs, maximum 2,000 MCQs in your hand. So for preparation of MCQ, everything hard copy. So in preparation of MCQ, you don't need much time. Where and all time permits, you can keep on, you can refer. So by way of reading MCQ, you'll have better grip over the syllabus, topics, and out of his few questions comes in the examination, you are the luckiest person. Third one, RTP. You have to gather RTP, 2 RTP sufficient, in which exam you are going to appear that particular RTP, and 1 more RTP. You don't need to read more than 2 RTPs. So that we can have the past revision, last minute revision also properly. MTP, minimum 6 MTPs we need to try to gather and download and take the printout of 6 MTPs. Every examination, institute is releasing 2 MTPs, except the previous exam. So 2 MTPs will be there. So try to download for every subject, 6 MTPs we need, past 6 MTPs. Gather the mock test paper and suggested answer also published by ICA, try to gather. And last one is suggested answer. Post exam suggested answer, minimum 5, maximum 7 suggested answer you have to refer. So everything should be there in the finger. Any question they are going to ask, you can be the person to tell. In that manner, you have to gather. Including taxation, gather, at least you know the trend of what is the question, because answer may not be the same because of the amendment. At least you know what type of question they are asking. The remaining papers, other than non-amendment oriented subjects, you can have the same question as it is. Sir, 7 suggested answer for new scheme may not possible. No, sir, old scheme possible. Yes, for new scheme, even the old scheme question paper you can download, and a common topic at least you can refer. So these are all the things you have to gather. I'll repeat, in your resource folder, 5 important things should be there, that too in hard copy. First one is short notes question and distinguished version question. First questions alone you can gather, minimum 100 short notes question and 40 distinguished between question. Second, MCQ, 2000 questions you have to gather for MCQ. Whatever the subjects MCQ applicable, those questions, those subjects. Third one, RTP, 2 RTP sufficient. And for next, fourth one, MTP, 6 MTPs you have to download, and the suggested answer 5 to 7 is advisable. So these are all the 5 things should be there in the resource folder. Then second thing, what you have to follow, articleship period. To clear the examination, you should be in the position to know how to make use of the articleship period properly. Articleship period plays a vital role, that too especially for the new scheme. If you are not having the strong articleship period, then understanding the question itself very difficult. Especially paper like FR and all ruled very difficult for you to attack in the main examination. The main problem with respect to CA student is, what is the problem in the problem in the main problem in the examination? They can't even the person to understand what are the question. It's purely because of they don't have the conceptual clarity properly. You can get the conceptual clarity only by way of doing the articleship properly. Without having articleship period, very difficult to understand the question paper itself. Then only can attack the main examination. Many of them, unless otherwise you come out from the comfort zone, very difficult to learn. If you want to grow, you have to come out from the comfort zone. I am comfortable with one particular article or one particular client, sir. I want to go on to do all the audits of the same client itself. Don't do like that. The 3 years, they'll go for the same clients only. Just because they are giving free bhojan, they want to enjoy. And going by bus and getting auto conveyance, they are very happy. Don't do like that. Once if you satisfy one particular client, you learned something from that client, go on to do the next client. If you are comfortable with the manufacturing company, go for the audit. Go and beg your auditor, I want to learn all varieties of the audit. Don't keep on go for the only one particular client. Within 3 years, you have to learn as much as possible you want. That will help you like anything to clear the examination and to face the interview also. So make use of the articleship anyway. Every student want to clear the examination. Anyway, all the student has to do the articleship properly. why don't you utilize in the better manner? To understand the better manner, I'll give you a small example story. One person prayed God, if I achieve the success particular set, I want to give 5 lakhs rupees donation to Tirupati Balaji temple. He want to give 5 lakhs rupees after achieving success. Two options are there. In general, everybody will do what? 5 lakhs rupees, they'll go and put it in Undiyal. They'll be happy. Okay? So, donation 5 lakhs over. Alternative option. Instead of putting 5 lakh rupees in Hundi, you can be in the position to get 500 rupees entry ticket from the Tirupati Devasthan. 5 lakhs rupees you have donated or given and he has purchased 500 rupees tickets. 1,000 tickets he has purchased. And 1,000 people who were standing in the line and free darshan or darshan has given for the ticket, 500 rupees ticket at free of cost. So he got the blessings from all the 1,000 candidates. And anyway, that 5 lakhs rupees went to Tirupati only. Therefore, which option is best? So we have to think different manner. Anyway, you are going to write the main examination. Why don't you satisfy the articleship period properly? Why don't you get the blessing from your clients? Why don't you get the blessing from your boss? Why don't you have the nice relationship with one or friends in your articleship period? So that you can be in the position to get the immediate job also properly with the blessings of all by way of gathering all the knowledge. So make use of the articleship period properly. And nowadays, campus entry also very, very difficult without doing the proper articleship period. If you want to get the guaranteed job, because acquiring qualification is different, becoming chartered accountant is different. By way of mugging up, you can be a water, clear the examination. But to want to become a chartered accountant, you have to gather the knowledge. So make use of the articleship period properly. And last 1 year of your articleship, you are eligible to go for industrial training. It is advisable to go for industrial training also. Minimum 10 months gap should be there to go for the industrial training. So in the last 1 year, you are eligible to go for industrial. The industrial training also form part of your articleship period. Then what you have to do, what you want to learn in 3 years, you have to learn within 2 years. Then only you can go for the industrial training. So make use of the articleship period properly. And industrial training is the extra one more star for you to get the job easily. Next, third one is what? Class. In general, everybody want to go to the class. If you are going for the class, mere going to the class alone is not sufficient. You have to prepare par with the water. You have to go along with the faculty. At any cost, you need to prepare a study plan, proper study plan and all. At any cost, faculty has to complete the portion on time. Therefore, before you are going to the next class, make sure what and all happened in the previous class. If you are going to complete that itself, what your plan is over. That is called a study plan for you. So that happily can complete, go along with the faculty, do the revision. Classroom discussion alone is not sufficient. Refer RTP or MTP, that particular topic, what are all the portions over, you have to go through. So then have a better grip. Immediately you can have the access to the faculty to ask the doubts also. And always follow in classroom. Mere attending the class alone is not sufficient. You have to participate, you have to interact, you have to ask the question. That is more important. So classroom, for the purpose of when we have to attend the final class, that is more important. That is what the many of my IP students ask the question, when they have to attend that class. The moment you join the articleship, 2.5 years gap is there to write the main examination, final examination. Remember one thing, the last six months, only for the purpose of revision only. You may going to get 3 months or 4 months study holiday. Strictly speaking, that is not a study holiday. That's a revision holiday only. Therefore, before that, you have to complete everything. Therefore, remaining how many years available for the purpose of your preparation? 2 years available. In the 2 years, I am splitting into six months period, because once in 6 months examination. 2 years is equal to how many 6 months? So, first year, two 6 months are there. Second year, totally 4 6 months are there. 8 papers you have to prepare. Therefore, in every 6 months, you have to complete 2 subjects. It is advisable, the moment you wrote to final IPC examination or intermediate examination, the moment you join articleship, then immediately if you want to go for class, if you plan to go for class, better to join in the first year itself, first year of articleship itself. Even well in advance also, absolutely no problem. The moment you join for the class, if you want mentally prepared to go for the class, which subject you have to go? always it is advisable to join the class for non-amendment oriented subjects. What are the non-amendment oriented? FR, there is no much amendment. SFM, there is no much amendment. Costing, there is no much amendment. So you have to choose what all the subject you want to choose. For example, the first 6 months, you are attending class for FR class, CFNL, cost accounts class, and the costing class. So the 6 months, you are going to concentrate only costing as well as FR alone. Thereafter, next 6 months, it is advisable to join SFM paper and auditing paper. I am not saying there is no amendment at all. Small amendment will be there, but that is manageable. Because of that, we count the portion untouched from the subject. So in year one, 4 subject over. Next year, I will go for law and any elective paper other than international taxation, because that is also amendment oriented. The last 6 months, you have to go for direct tax and GST indirect tax. If you are going to prepare in this angle, the last 6 months of your what examination before the last 6 months of your articleship, that is what 2.5 years, after 2 years, you can be the person to concentrate only for the purpose of revision. So that you can write more model examination also. So attend the class and write the model examination, that will help you like anything. And next one is 3:1 ratio. The fourth rule is 3:1 ratio. What is called a 3:1 ratio? If anyway you are attending the class, in general 3 hours class will be there, roughly 3 hours class. If you are attending 3 hours session, 1 hour from the your side revision is must. Even the God is going to take the class, without your preparation you can't clear the exam. Therefore 3:1 ratio must. 3 hours class mean at least 1 hour from your side preparation, revise, thereafter only have to go to the next class. While doing the revision, mock test is also equally important. At least 3 classes over, at least one topic over, you have to write the mock test. Topic wise test you have to write, or test series you have to write. So write the model exam. Writing one model exam is equal to avoiding one attempt. If you want to avoid that attempt, you have to write more and more model exam. So the 3:1 ratio you have to follow. Parallel you have to write the revision, parallel you have to write the test also. Therefore, end of one particular subject class over, you have to be thorough with all the topics properly. That is called 3:1 ratio. Mere morning to evening, if you are going to keep on, you are going to attend the class, you not even have the time to revise. Immediately going for the next class, many of them not even have the time to have the proper food properly. Then how can you able to clear the exam? Therefore, follow 3:1 rule so that that will help you to clear the examination. And last one is mobile. How to make use of the mobile? Mobile, we can be the person to make use to the core. That is the extra one more teacher coming along with you always. Therefore, without having mobile, nowhere we are going. Then why don't you utilize the instrument properly? Whether you are slave to the mobile, whether mobile is what your servant, you have to analyze. Whenever you are going to prepare, because everybody is using the mobile properly. Businessman knows how to use the mobile properly. Believe it or not, last week I went to Apollo Pharmacy to purchase one ointment, knee pain ointment for my neighbor. In Apollo Pharmacy, they asked my contact number. I have given my contact number. They said points will be there, sir. All things they told. Believe it or not, within 4 or 5 days, I got one message from Apollo Pharmacy. This is what the message, just I wrote also. Dear one Apollo member, meet ortho expert for knee or back or shoulder pain. For free consultant, for consult, contact this particular number at Apollo Hospital, the phone number near to my house, what Apollo Hospital is there, that message has come. See the businessman, how they are making use, what type of tablet or what type of ointment, what type of medicine I am purchasing. Accordingly, they are filtering the customer and they are sending that particular message so that they are making use of the customer's data properly. They are making use of the technology properly. They are making use of the mobile properly. Businessman knows how to make use of the mobile. Why not you? You are a professional. You are going to be a chartered accountant. At any cost, want or don't want in examination, you have to write the all sufficient point you have to write. If you have to write, you have to remember first. If you want to remember, you have to revise properly. If you want to revise, you don't have the time at all. Because morning to evening, you are having articleship period and a class. Where is the question of what revision time? Therefore, make use of the mobile properly. Whenever you are having, at least per day, every students are wasting 2 hours during travel. Traveling time minimum 2 hours will be there. At least half an hour to 1 hour waiting time will be there in the departments or in the client place and all. So why don't you make use of 2 to 2.5 hours by way of mobile? If you are going to read, whenever you are going to prepare for the examination, whenever you are attending the class, you have to read 8 points, 12 points, 13 points. You have to remember all the points. The first time you are going to read, record in the mobile. If you are going to record, and thereafter going to convert, you can convert into playlist also. And keep on, if you are going to revise by way of what playing those records, you can want or don't want, you can be in the position to what remember all the points properly, 8 points, 12 points, 6 points, because mobile is keep on going to shout you. Once if you record, that itself more than sufficient. No? All the, you can't expect everything from the faculty will give everything, pen drive, even the recorder voice. We can't do. We have to do. Anyway, you are going to study proper, you are going to study, no? Why don't you make use of the mobile? So that mobile is going to be a servant for you. The moment you wake up, even to the brushing time, if you are going to keep on the mobile, keep on, it will shout. It will go inside. Automatically, you can be in the position to remember all the points. Traveling time, instead of listening the music, as if you are more tired, you want to get relaxed. If you are going to listen your own voice, if you are going to revise all the points properly, revision over. Automatically, you can be in the position to retain all the points. Therefore, make use of the mobile properly. And after having mobile, there is no chance to fail in the main examination. You can eligible to get the rank also, provided you should know how to make use of the mobile. If you are going to use the mobile for all unwanted purposes, it's going to kill your time only. Therefore, remember 5 things. It's a winning strategy for the purpose of final examination. If you are going to make use of the 5 things properly, guaranteed to pass with the rank, sir. What are the 5 things? I'll sum up. First one, resource folder you have to create. In that resource folder, 5 things you're supposed to have. That in hard copy. Second one, how to make use of the articleship period. Third one, how to attend the class, when to attend the class. Next one, 3:1 ratio. And last one, mobile. With these 5 things, guaranteed success. Wish you all the very best for examination. Bye-bye.